Welcome back to this video lecture series on programming questions for placement preparation. So today the problem we're going to see is finding the lowest common ancestor in a binary search tree. So we all know that this is a diagram of a binary search tree. In binary search tree, all the nodes that appear left to the root is having lesser values than the root, and all the nodes appear in the right will be having greater values than the node. So the problem statement here is, given a binary search tree, find the common ancestor of given any two nodes. So for example, if we are given these two nodes, 14 and 4. So if we are to find the common ancestor, then it will be 8. It basically means that we have to find the common parent of both of the nodes. So you see, 4 is having 8 as its parents, and 14 is having 8 also as its parents via this 12. So 8 is the common ancestor of 4 and 14. Likewise, 4 and 22, for these two nodes the common ancestor will be 20, and for 10 and 14 the common ancestor will be 12. So let's have a look at the approach we will be taking to solve this problem. We will run a loop while the root of the tree is not null. Now, if the root has a value greater than both of the given node values, then traverse from left child. If the root has a value lesser than both of the given node values, then traverse from the right child. Otherwise, we'll break the loop, and after loop termination, return the root at the lowest common ancestor. So basically, here we will first take these two nodes. Suppose 4 and 14 are given. We will check whether these two values are greater than, both of them are greater than these value 20. Basically, we will start from this root. So root value at the first or at the beginning will be 20. So we see that 4 is lesser than 20 and 14 is also lesser than 20. So the first condition doesn't satisfy, that both of these are not greater than this. The second condition is that whether both of these are less than this, less than 20. So we see yes, that 4 and 14 are lesser than 20. So what we do, we traverse for the left child. So we come to 8, and now 8 is the root. Then again we check 4 and 14, whether both of them are greater than 8. We see no, 4 is less, 14 is greater than, but 4 is not greater than 8. Then again we check whether 4 and 14, both of them are lesser than 8. We see 4 is less than 8, but 14 is not. So at that point, what we do, we return this node as the result, because this point we will find the common ancestor. So we will try to implement this logic in the code. So let's jump onto the programming part. So I have already typed down the code to actually create the binary search tree, and I have also did the in order traversal of this binary search tree. So I have taken this binary search tree as an example, where 8 is the root, 5 the left children, and 10 the right children, like that. So now I will write the code to find the common ancestor. For that I'll need the two nodes for which I will try to find the common ancestor. So let me take those variables, A and B will be the two nodes, and there will be a common ancestor. So now I'll print a value to the user that will say enter the nodes, and I will take those values, so C in A and C in B. Now I will find the common ancestor, and I'll pass the root of the binary search tree and both of the nodes. Lastly, I'll print the common ancestor is the common ancestor and an end line. So the only work for us is to define this function. So this function will actually return an integer type return value, because it will actually return the node value. So here it is, the arguments. The first one will be a struct node type, that is a pointer to the node of the binary search tree, and two integer variables having the node values for which we actually need to find the common ancestor. So first we'll check if the root is null. So if the root is null, what we will return? We will return 0. Now if this is not the condition, then we'll check for conditions. Like first, if a is greater than the root data and b is also greater than the root data, then what we will do, we will recur for the right child. So root right, otherwise, so I'll use an else if here. Let me just copy this part of the code. So there will be else if a is less than root data and b is also less than root data, then we will recur for the left child. And if this is also not the case, then what we will simply do, we'll return this root data. So that is the simple logic. So let's now run this code and see the output. Okay, so we have actually have an error here because for obvious reason I have to pass all the parameters to this function. So I'll also need to pass the a and b here. So yeah, now it's okay. So let's run it again. So here is the output we have got. You see, for this tree, this is the in order traversal. So it asked me to enter the nodes. So let me find the common ancestor of 3 and 10, which should be 8. So I'll enter 3 first, then 10, and the answer is, the common ancestor is 8. So you see, it works perfectly. So that was the simple and easy logic for finding the lowest common ancestor in a binary search tree. Thank you for watching this video and staying with us. See you next time.